Hi, I'm Veena Sahajwalla, and I'm an ARC Laureate Professor here at UNSW in Sydney and Director of the Smart Centre. Being one of the world's first e-waste microfactories, we're really all about developing new science and new technology so that it is possible to take something as challenging as electronic waste and make something positive out of it.
E-waste was actually one of the toughest issues that we looked at in the war on waste. Everyone's looking for solutions right now and talking about circular economies, but without the passion and the knowledge of somebody like Veena, you won't find the solutions. You won't actually find the ways to use materials and reuse them and get as much life out of them as possible.
E-waste has this enormous impact on our lives, whether it's our phones, our computers, what happens to those end-of-life electronic products, and is moving to see how people who are working in so many disadvantaged communities globally are being affected by e-waste.
When I first walked into Veena's microfactory, I was surprised by how micro it is. It's actually remarkably small. She's got mini lightning strikes to blow phones apart. She's looking for all different ways to use the materials.
And we can literally fragment various products, and we can isolate our plastics and our circuit boards. What the robotic arm then can do is identify the exact components that we want. Using these waste plastics, we can then convert them into plastic filaments. So imagine plastic wires. We can use these plastic wires from waste plastics for 3D printing. So all of a sudden now, this waste plastic can actually be brought to life into a completely different product.
At Dresden, we've got a really simple mission. What we want to do is make glasses accessible and affordable. And a key to that is using recycled and sustainable materials. When we started the journey with manufacturing with Dresden, we realized we needed to reach out because we were new to manufacturing. We turned to University of New South Wales and they straight away recommended Veena. The research work that Veena's doing really overlaps with our work, because what we're doing with the frames is using alternative sources of waste plastics that are actually high quality but are currently not reused. And e-waste fully fits that category. So the grant that we won in partnership with Veena and her team is a 3-year project, and we're developing the automation and the reprocessing technology so that e-waste and other waste plastics can be incorporated into our Dresden frame.
It's really fantastic to have partnerships with people like Bruce. We have the common goals. Effectively, what we are showing to the world is if plastic waste coming from e-waste can in fact be transformed into a really useful consumer product like spectacles, then there are endless possibilities.
One of the big worries with recycling at the moment in Australia is a lack of trust about what's actually happening to the recycling. And so having products that can actually be felt and tangibly worn on the face is the kind of thing that shows people, look, your recycling is going somewhere. We are finding solutions for it.
The fact that we can produce these beautiful, high-quality plastic filaments out of waste and use it for printing, it means that we're opening up a whole new economy where microfactories become part of the supply chain, creating new products out of recycled materials.
The opportunity is massive, and if we can get it right, you know, e-waste is really critical, because if we can solve all the problems to do with that, then we can solve a lot of other downstream recycling issues.
So often I go to areas and regional areas and they say, look, we can't get our material to market, but with a small portable microfactory, you can actually deal with those problems all over the place, looking at the materials that we're throwing away and finding new ways to give them a new life.
We believe that microfactories can actually have a huge impact across the world. Our ability to process e-waste means that as engineers, we do have that knowledge and we do have that capacity in our hands to make a real difference for our economy and for our environment.